Welcome to my channel Ezzy Lit. Today we do a formal letter regarding job application, which is usually used by the 12th graders of CBSE. Job application letters are usually written in a very formal way, very precise and to the point. One should not go round and round in this sort of a letter. And usually a biodata or a resume is attached in a formal letter, that is, in which you have the details regarding the name of the candidate, date of birth, educational qualifications, professional achievements, experience, previous experience, hobbies, marital status, sometimes salary expected, and extremely important is the references. So a biodata again is not usually attached or not written with the main letter. It's usually you write biodata attached or resume enclosure, and then you make a table and give all these details. We take a sample question, that is, wanted postgraduate teacher in science to teach senior secondary classes in a reputed school. Candidates should have a minimum of 2 years of teaching experience. Apply to box number 215, care of The Hindu, Mumbai 300013. So we start with the address, that is the one who is sending, the sender's address. Then we leave a line, we write the date. And as we all know, in a formal letter, you don't put the TH over here. And after the month, a comma. Again, leave a line. Now here in your question, they have not given you the name of the school. They have told you to apply to this box number, this address. So you write the advertiser. Please do not put a 2 above this. The advertiser, box number 215, care of The Hindu, Mumbai 300013. Again, leave a line, your salutation, sir. Leave a line, subject. Usually we write the subject in block letters, capital letters, so that it's very, very obvious. And you can, of course, underline it. Again, leave a line. Your first paragraph starts with, from where did you get this information regarding this vacancy? So I've written, with response to your advertisement in The Hindu, dated 12th July 2019. The advertisement date will be before the date of your letter. So I've kept it 2 days earlier, 12th July. I would like to apply for the post of senior secondary science teacher in your institution. Next paragraph. Attached herewith is my brief resume. You can write biodata too. If considered for this post, I assure you that I will work diligently, that is, sincerely, in a hard-working way, and surely add value to your team of teachers. So the first paragraph is from where you have got the information and you're saying you would like to apply for it. Second paragraph, you say that you have attached your resume and you try to convince the person to whom you are sending this letter that you would surely be of great help, of great value, and you'll work with sincerity and dedication. So that is your second paragraph. And your closing is thanking you, yours truly, and your name. No commas anyway, no apostrophe, and your truly, please remember, does not have an E. This is a mistake very, very often repeated. TRULY.
you can close it. Your biodata, maybe copies of certificates, a passport size photo. Then we start with biodata. This is all your personal information in the beginning. Your name, date of birth, father's name, gender, marital status, address form, communication, and you can also add hobbies.
Then comes your qualifications, and this is always in a table. It has to start from your present to the past. That is what you have mastered in and to the last. So you have MSc in chemistry, Mumbai University, and your percentage or the class you have secured. And as I had, the question was for a science teacher, my degree, my qualifications have to relate to the science stream. Please don't make an error and write something about another stream which has no relation to the question asked. Again, it's a teacher's post. Education usually, not usually, always asks for this degree, that is Bachelor's of Education, which is always done after your graduation. So before my master's, I have done B.Ed. So Mumbai University, and again the division. Then graduation, I've put B.Sc. Then my higher secondary, secondary. These two you have to write the board, CBSE or your state board or whatever pertains to it. But if it's a teacher's job, it's usually a B.Ed. If it's a professor or a higher post in an educational institution, you can also add Ph.D. So this way you please relate to what the question has asked. If it's regarding a manager, you can add an MBA with a B.Com degree and so on and so forth, or BBA. Then is the work experience. Again, from the current to the past. At present, teaching in Podar High School, Mumbai, and I've put from April 2017 as class 9th and 10th chemistry teacher. Then I've put April 2014 to March 2017 worked in Central High School as class 8th chemistry teacher. Then is your reference, very, very important. I've added two. Professor A.K. Rathod of Mumbai University. Second, Principal Sir Mr. A.R. Chauhan of Central High School. You can add their address, or as I've put, I've just added their mobile numbers. We start with the address. No commas, leave a line, the date, leave a line, the advertiser, box number 215, care of the Hindu, Mumbai, your pin code. And we have put the advertiser because the name of the school is not put in your question, only this box number is given. Again, leave a line, salutation, leave a line, subject, application for the post of science, senior secondary teacher. Keep it in block letters. Again, leave a line. With response to your advertisement in The Hindu, dated 12th July 2019. Now remember, your letter written that date and this date, there should be a difference. The advertisement will always be before, the date will be before you start writing your letter. So it's 12th and here it's 14th. I would like to apply for the post of senior science teacher in your institution. Then the next paragraph where I say what all I am going to put forward. Attached herewith is my brief resume. If considered for this post, I assure you that I will work diligently, that is sincerely, in a hard working way, and surely add value to your team of teachers. So in your first paragraph you say from where you have got the know-how regarding this vacancy. So you write the name of the paper and the date and for what position you are applying. The second para, you will talk about what all you are adding on, that is your resume, your qualifications, your marital status and so on. You again leave a line and write eagerly awaiting for a positive reply or eagerly awaiting an anticipation. Leave a line thanking you, yours truly, and the name. Please see that the name relates to the question if given. Again, there will be no apostrophe for yours, and truly is truly. There is no E over here, which is a very, very common error made by students, and no commas.